study about a water vascular or the ambulacral system of the astreas. Astreas is from the phylum Echinodermata. Presence of water vascular system is the unique feature of anatomy of all echinoderms. It is derived from the coelom, from which it separates during the development of the animal. Thus, it is a modified part of the coelom. Water vascular system of the astreas is start with a madreporite, then stone canal, then drain canal, then the tedman's body, then the pollen vesicle, then the radial canal, lateral canal, and it ends into the tube feet. We'll see one by one. First one, that is the madreporite. The water vascular system starts with a madreporite, which is the hard, rounded, calcareous plate-like a structure on the aboral surface. Body of the sea star or the astreas is the disc-like, pentamerous, or the radially symmetrical. It having two surfaces, oral surface and the aboral surface. Oral surface that having the mouth that facing always toward the downwards or the bottom of the water body, and the aboral surface which having the anus and the madreporite that facing towards the surface of the water body. So the madreporite is situated at the bases of two arms, that is called as interradii position, and that two arms are termed as a bivium. The portion of the arms from the central point to the tip of arm is called as a radii, and the portion in between the bases of two arms is called as a interradii. So the madreporite is situated at the interradii position, and that two arm is called as a bivium, and the remaining three arms are called as a trivium. Madreporite is situated is on the aboral surface. Now that disc like part consists of many ridges or the many radiating grooves or the furrows also, having at their bottom minute ciliated pores. There are about 200 to 250 pores are present in each furrow, which lead into the short canal, that is called as a pore canal. There are many pore canals that unite to form a collecting canal. The latter in turn open into the small sac-like structure, that is called as a ampulla, which is just lying below the madreporite. Then next part of madreporite is a stone canal. Stone canal that opens into the vertically into the ring canal, but it is supported by the series of the calcareous ridges, hence it is called as a stone canal. The lumen of stone canal is lined by the tall flagellated ciliated cells. The movement of cilia draws the water current into the canal. On one side of its wall projects into the cavity, that is a ridge that bifurcates into the two lamellae, or which roll spirally. Then next part, that is the ring canal. Ring canal is a wide, five-sided, pentagonal, ring-like structure situated just around the mouth. Then next part, that is the tedman's body. A ring canal on its inner side gives off a pair of small vesicles, that is called as a tedman's body, or it is also called as a racemose glands. These are small, yellowish, irregular, rounded glandular bodies. Then there are about a 9 tedman's bodies. 10th position is taken by the opening of the stone canal. Then we'll see the functions of the tedman's body. Exact function of tedman's body is unknown, but they may consider as a lymphatic gland to manufacture the amebocytes, as well as they are produce the phagocytic coelomocytes. Then the next part, that is the pollen vesicle. In astreas, that are the absent, but in most of the sea star, the pollen vesicles are the present. The number is a variable, that is about a 2 to 4 in a number, and they are present at the interradial position periphery to the ring canal. Then the functions of the Pollen vesicle, they may stores the water as well as they regulate the pressure in a water vascular system as well as they manufacture the amoebocyte cells. Then next part, that is the radial canal. Ring canal from its border at a 5 corners, it may give out a 5 radial canals. The radial canals run up to the tip of the arm. Then from each side of the radial canal, that is, arises the lateral canal. Next structure, that is a lateral canal. During the course of the radial canal, it gives off on either side a small ducts or the canals. They are about a short and long. They are two in a two rows, but due to the alternate short and long, they may be appear as a 4 rows. See here, one row of a long arms, second row of short, third row of short, and the fourth row of a long lateral canal. Then lateral canal, when open at the part of the ampulla of tube feet, it is provided with a wall, so it prevents the back flow of the water from the tube feet to the lateral canal, or the reverse flow of the water current, that is avoided due to the wall present at the tip of the lateral canal where it opens into the tube feet. Next structure, that is the tube feet. Tube feet, they are actually present in a 2 alternating rows, but they may be appear as in a 4 rows. Each tube feet, that may be consists of the 3 parts. The solemn part is called as ampulla, tubular part is called as podium, and the disc-like terminal part is called as a sucker. Tube feet, they are considered for the locomotion and the respiration purpose in a osteus. Whole the water vascular system, that is lined with a ciliated or the flagellated cells, they may produce the water current, and they may be helpful for the sending water or the flowing water from the that part to the next part. So it starts with a madreporite, ends into the tube feet. So a madreporite acts as a sieve like plate for the intake of water, and the tube feet or the sucker from where the water is leaving from the water vascular system. Now we'll see the functions of water vascular system. First function is a locomotion, where the terminal portion of the tube feet, that is a sucker, it may helpful for the attachment to the substratum. Then the excretion, removal of nitrogenous waste material. Then the respiration, that is the gaseous exchange. Then the body attachment with the help of sucker to the substratum or the any object. Then the reproduction, they may be helpful for the food capturing. Thank you.